Dr. Gilesh MP, Secretary, Government Engineering College, Vayanad. Dr. Biju K, Assistant Professor, College of Engineering, Munnar, Treasurer. Sibu MS, Senior Technician, VSSC ISRO. Hasina PY, Assistant Professor, College of Engineering, Karnagapalli. Tasneema Fatima NK, Assistant Professor, MES College of Engineering, Kuttipuram. Bindima T, Assistant Professor, GEC Kozhikode. Rijil Ramachandran, Professor, NIT Calicut. Hamid Abdurrahman, Director, TechnoWave LLC, USA. Jitin Krishnan, Scientist, SCT IMST, Government of India. Penny Roy, Associate Software Engineer, Key Value Software Systems. Sabik PV, Principal, KMCT EW. Sean Jones, Associate Manager, Course 5I. Shankar J, Assistant Professor, UK. Suraj S, Assistant Professor, MDit, Kozhikode. Nandan S, Assistant Professor, LBS ITW. Santosh Kumar, Professor, CUSAT. Ajit Gobi, Joint Chief Technical Manager, ANERT. Hari Kumar, Associate Engineer, KSEBC. Dr. Aldrin Anthony, Associate Professor, CUSAT. Shashi PM, IEEE member. Anu Mohammed, GEC Barton Hill. Mrudula L, Professor, MESC, Kuttipuram. Dr. Chinmay, Professor, IAST. Dr. Arpan TJ, President, NEST. Shamla BVA, Research Scholar, NIT Calicut. Atul Jose P, PG Scholar, NIT Calicut. OAS Manzoor, PG Student, NIT Calicut. Rahul S, Research Scholar, NIT Calicut. EUCAT. Vasanti V, Professor, NSSC Palakkad. Assistant Professor, GEC Palakkad. Dr. Meenakshi K, Professor, GEC Thrissur. Link team members, Archa Varadraj. Abhirami Chandramouli. Annaga N. Anamika S. Pisharadi. Anuvinda Krishnan VK. Arjun Sunil Kumar. Arundhati Krishna. Basil Reji. Femi Shaju. Fida Fatima. Ganga MK. Joel John Kandathil. K. Thomas Matthew. Melvin Thomas. Pranav JR. Rosa Mariam John. S. Sri Vidya. Sri Lakshmi M. Rajiv. Abdul Ahmad Ras, Representative. Alan Sabu, RFID Representative. Govind S. Warrior, SPS Representative. Josna VR, Assistant Professor, GEC Barton. Anu George, Assistant Professor, CET Trivandrum. Shamna HR, Associate Professor, GC Barton Hill. Madhu Krishnan AP. Amira Sharon, Software Engineer, Key Value. Salif Youssef, Entry App. Arvind P. Unnithan, Software Engineer, Z-Link. Karthik K, Engineering Manager, IIA. Shailesh S, Assistant UX Engineer. Shabira TP, Lecturer, Kerala Government Polytechnic College. Reshna S, Associate Professor, TKMC. Job Chungat, Assistant Professor in EC, GC Kozhikode. Ananya R, Community Manager, Google Developer. Midun M, Software Engineer, IRZ Marketing. Varun Menon, Associate Professor, SCMS School of Engineering. Sharath S, SAC EDSOC KC. Adina MR, Scrum Master, High Peak Software Private Limited. Devika S, Salesforce Developer, Community America Credits. Guys De Cruz, Data Engineer, Cubeburst. Aisha EA, Content Writer, EDSOC. Nishant Benny, SR Comsoc Kerala. Abdul Ahad, SR RAS Kerala Chapter. Govind S. Warrior, Design Head, IEEE SPS Kerala Chapter. Hari Govind, IEEE PES YP. Abhinav R., Product Strategist, Divyang. Paul Ansel, Senior Maker, AISAT. Sheetal Siriak, Research Scholar, NIT Calicut. Rinsha V, Research Scholar, NIT Calicut. Mohammed Rashid KK, MDC, IEEE PES Kerala Chapter. C, IEEE Malabar Sajin S. EDSOC. Nishant Benny, ComSoc. Amit Tony Joseph, Pai. Bharat Srinivasan, Site. Aisha E. EDSOC. Atul Rajvi, CS.
So, Pooja, you can, if everybody is covered over here. Okay, then on the Zoom, those on the Zoom, please ask them to, yeah. So I'll request the Exico members on Zoom to please introduce.
Damodaran VK.
Yes, Damodaran VK joining from Trivandrum online.
Bijoy Jose.
Dr. Bijoy Jose, Associate Professor Kusat.
Deepa AK.
I think Deepa is available here. Maybe you can go to the next person and then see.
Dr. Jisha VR.
Yes, Disha, Associate Professor, Seek.
Gopakumar, sir.
I'm Gopakumar, Professor, MES College, Pettipuram.
Lillikutty Jacob.
I'm Lillikutty Jacob, I'm a retired professor from NIT Calicut. Mm-hmm.
Sridev Shyam KV.
Hi all, I'm Sridesh Shyam. I'm product manager working at Key Valley Software Systems.
Unni Shankar.
Hello. Unni Shankar, work in Quest Global, first chair of Kerala section, and currently the chair of the TELES committee.
Vargi CM.
Good evening, one and all. CM Varghese, CEO of Evergreen Energy Technologies Limited, Cochin, and also the Chair of Education Society Chapter. Thank you.
Dr. Suresh Nair.
Hello, I'm Suresh Nair, joining from Orlando now. I was the past chair of IEEE Kerala Section, currently chair of India Council. Thank you.
Okay, I understand everybody has been introduced. Thank you so much. Let me welcome Professor Mohammad Qasim, Vice Chair Kerala Section, to deliver the welcome speech.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening to one and all. Respected President of the meeting, Mrs. Sarada Jayakrishnan, Dr. Gilesh, Dr. Biju, life senior members of IEEE present over here, senior members, members, EXICOM members, EXICOM members present over the online Zoom meeting, YP members, and all the family members who are present here. Welcome to one and all again. I am proud to stand before you as a senior member of IEEE, the world's largest professional organization standing for advancing technology for the benefit of humanity. IEEE, with more than 412,000 members worldwide in more than 160 countries in 10 regions. IEEE activities in Kerala started with the formation as a subsection in 1975 under then India's section, then transferred to Bangalore subsection in 1976 with the formation of India Council. Kerala section became a full section in 1983 with Dr. KPP Nambiar as the founder chair. The first student branch was formed at College of Engineering Trivandrum with Dr. Gomadi K. Muralidharan as the student branch counselor. Kerala section is currently with two subsections, 13 technical society chapters, one joint chapter, one technical council chapter, 4 affinity group chapters, then 88 active student branches, 220 plus student branch chapters, and 15 standing committees. 3 chapters, namely Power and Energy Society Chapter, Computer Society Chapter, IEEE PLS Joint Chapter, are globally ranked number 1, number 2, and number 3 in terms of membership count. Newly formed Education Society Chapter has got a membership growth of 600% in a short span of 8 months. And it stands top among Region 10. Among standing committees, the programs organized by inter-society activities led by Mr. A.J. Harindralal sir was worth mentioning. Inter-society completed 91 webinars without any break in 2020 and 2021. Kerala's Malabar subsection is also conducting this webinar series, and it is also going very smoothly, and it is known as the Thursday Talks and the Inter-Society Talks as the Wednesday Talks. Kerala section witnessed a record increase of more than 52% in senior member elevation in 2021. Currently, we have 322 senior members and 25 live senior members in our section. Kerala section bagged too many laurels in 2019, 2020, and 2021, including R10 Outstanding Large Section Award, MGA Outstanding Large Section Award, Society Chapter, MGA Membership Retention and Growth Award, then society chapter awards and too many individual volunteer awards. It's a vibrant with more than say 3,700 activities for 2021 Kerala section. So see the vibrancy of Kerala section, and it is because of the vibrancy of Kerala section we are bagging too many awards in the form of outstanding large section award, in the form of membership retention and membership growth award, and this volunteer awards. Include 2022 new members, 2022 renewed members, and 2022 yet to renew members. And I request all the EXCO members to take initiatives to see that all the pending members are renewing their membership for 2022 to keep the vibrancy and the number one position of Kerala section. I request all the EXCO members and the volunteers to take the relevant or required initiatives to get all the members renewed for 2022. Now, let me come to my official duty of welcoming all of you to this function. I welcome Mrs. Sharada Jayakrishnan, the current chair of IEEE Kerala section and the president of this meeting, to this function on all of us, on behalf of all of us present here, and on behalf of those who are present on Zoom meeting. Next, I welcome Dr. Gilesh, the secretary of IEEE Kerala section, Dr. Biju, the treasurer of Kerala section, the immediate past chair, Dr. Sabir, and senior members, and our EXCO members, all EXCO members, and the upcoming chair, Mini Ulanat, Dr. Mini Ulanat, and the YPs, all volunteers, and all members who are attending this function online and offline. I thank all of you in joining this annual general meeting. Restrictions imposed by to 150, and some members are unable to register and join this meeting, and it is not because that we are not interested, it is because of the section Kerala state imposed restrictions, and please bear with us. Thank you. And
the code of ethics, and request our past chair, Mr. Shashi PM, to please read out and be with us. I'll request everybody to please stand up.
I will read out the code of ethics. I request all of you to repeat the code of ethics. We, the members of the IEEE, in recognition of the importance of our technologies in affecting the quality of life throughout the world, and in accepting a personal obligation to our profession, its members, and the communities we serve, do hereby commit ourselves to the highest ethical and professional conduct, and agree 1, to hold paramount the safety, health, and to protect the privacy of others and to disclose promptly factors that might endanger the public or the environment. Conventional and emerging technologies, including intelligent systems. When they do exist, to avoid unlawful conduct in professional activities, and to reject bribery in all its forms, to seek, accept, and offer honest criticism of technical work, to acknowledge and correct errors, to be honest and realistic in stating claims or estimates based on available data, and to credit properly the contributions of others. To maintain and improve our technical competence and to undertake technological tasks for others, only if treat all persons fairly and with respect, and to not to engage in discrimination based on characteristics such as race, religion, gender, disability, age, national origin, sexual orientation, gender identity, or gender expression. To not engage in harassment of any kind, including sexual harassment or bullying behavior. To avoid injuring others, their property, reputation, or employment by false or malicious actions, rumors, or any other verbal or physical abuses. To support colleagues and co-workers in following this code of ethics, to strive to ensure the code is upheld, and to not retaliate against individuals reporting a violation. Thank you.
Thank you, Shashi, for entering the code of ethics. We will move on to the next item on the agenda, which is presenting the annual report. I'll request the Secretary of Kerala Section 21, Dr. Alesh MP, to kindly present.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The 2020 AGM was so much comfortable for me because I was presenting the annual report using my Kylie. It was much easier, but this time it feels comfortable. So 2021 has been a year of transcending stereotypes and striving towards a new normal. And we are recovering from the impact of COVID-19. So we'll start with the report. Currently, Kerala Section is the largest section in the world with 13,513 members as in today. And last year, we have won several accolades, including the Artin Membership Growth Large Section Award 2021, the first MGA Innovation Award 2021, and we have conducted several international or national events, including the AISY WLC 2021 of India Council, the Artin POCO, and the student-led conference, IPRICON. We have many of our volunteers serving in higher committees of IEEE, including the MGA. We have Dr. Suresh Nair serving as the chair of IEEE India Council, Dr. Sameer SM serving as the secretary of Artin, Mr. Amadnath Raja serving as chair of IEEE MRR, Mr. Satish Babu serving as IEEE MGA Awards Committee member, Sridhar Shyam serving as a member of MGA IEEE TV Advisory Committee, Mr. Vagis Charyan as the industry rep to MGA Students Activities Committee, Ms. Dr. Mini Ulanat as member at large at IEEE Women in Engineering Committee, as well as the Computer Society MGA Board. Mr. Jagrishan MC is a member of IEEE Humanitarian Activities Committee. And last year, we have formed two society chapters. One as Education Society chapter, which is very recent. And prior to that, we have Education Society chapter first and then Politics Society very recently. For those who are new to IEEE statistics, we have two subsections in Kochi and Malabar. We have 14 societies, which includes one joint chapter, 4 affinity groups, one council chapter and community, and we have several activity groups, or we otherwise call it as standing committees. The statistics on the membership, we are at 13,513 as on today, which is approximately 30 plus percentage of increase from last year. And this is a society with split of memberships, in which you can see the Computer Society chapter, which has 3,444 members, at the second largest society across the world. The new chapter, Education Society, has 112 members. The joint chapter, IEEPLS, has 3,061 members. The Power and Energy Society, which is the largest, I'm sorry for the font, has 40-30 members. And then the Photonic Society, the recent one, has 1,239. As I said, we have several accolades received this year, which includes, before going to the accolades received, last year onwards, we had actually bifurcated the annual general meeting into annual plus awards function into separate annual general meeting and then awards night. So last year, the awards night happened on 30th of Jan 2021, and the public award, KPP Nambiar Award, was bestowed upon Dr. M.S. Valiathan. And we have several other awards also distributed on the same day. That's all listed there. We also had give away the volunteer awards on the same night. These are all the winners of awards, and we have best event also just emerged 2020 by the YP team. As I told you, the Mint platform, which was developed for volunteer interaction, won the IEEE MGA Innovation Awards 2021. And this is a first edition of the award, which was backed by Kerala Section. The YP team of IEEE Kerala Section won the IEEE Hall of Fame Award 2021. Congratulations to Professor Sunita Bibi, who won the 2021 MGA IEEE Inspiring Member of the Year Award. Dr. Biju K won the Outstanding Chapter Advisor from IEEE IASCMD. Professor Damodaran VK won the
Region 10 Life Member Outstanding Volunteer Award 2021. Shankar J. Jairaj, Activities Students Activities Committee Chair, won the Young Professionals Outstanding Volunteer in Academics Award from Region 10. In the India Council Awards, we have Professor Mohammad Kasing winning the India Council Outstanding Volunteer Award 2021. Professor K.P. Mohandas won IEEE IC Lifetime Achievement Award 2021. Jacob Thomas Pudukeril won the IEEE IC Outstanding Young Professionals Award 2021. This award is outside IEEE. Dr. Chinmay Saha, who is the chair of MTTS chapter, won the AICT Visheshwaraya Best Teacher Award this year. And we have few other awards for student branch counselors and advisors. Biranjit P.S., the Outstanding Branch Counselor Award 2021. Professor Deepa A.K. won the Outstanding Branch Chapter Advisor Award 2021. And Professor Pradeepa P.K. won the Outstanding Branch Chapter Advisor Award 2021. Our students won 15 of our students, colleges won Daryl Chong Student Activity Award this year. And 9 student branches from Kerala won the IEEE Regional Exemplary Student Branch Award in 2021. Now, as I said, AISY WLC was one of the major events that was hosted by Kerala Section in 2021 recently, which happened on 1st, 11th, 18th, and 19th of December. And the more updates will be given by Shankar in his presentation on students' activities. We had organized 8 conferences. I'm sorry for this presentation. I'm presenting from Google Slides, so maybe there's some overlap. But we have 8 conferences, which was technically co-sponsored by IEEE Kerala Section, out of which 1 conference, which was hosted by NIT Calicut, was the first financially co-sponsored conference by IEEE Kerala Section. Now, the IEEE celebrations happened on October 10th of 2021, which was a hybrid event happening at both Trivandrum and Kochi offices of IEEE, where the IEEE CS President-elect Ms. Nita Patel was the chief guest, and Deepak Mathur, Region 10 Director, also joined the meeting. And this is one of the milestones of IEEE Kerala Section. We have inaugurated the IEEE Kochi office in August and also renovated the IEEE Trivandrum office. You can see the offices there. And this all happened because of the surplus fund we earned from the TenCon 2019. And I would like to thank Dr. Sameer SM and Dr. Suresh Nair, who are the general chairs of TenCon 2019. We have been publishing newsletters every quarter. 3 e-newsletters has been published. These are the first pages of, or the cover pages of those newsletters. And this is the annual edition of our newsletter. I request our chair to declare it as released.
Yeah, thank you to Gopalan sir for making it sure that we get every quarter we get the news of our events disseminated to all our members. The first 3 quarters, it's generally an e-newsletter, and the last one is always a in-print newsletter. We couldn't bring it over in the venue over here, but this will be disseminated to the members. So I declare that has been released. Thank you.
Another important move in Kerala Section was establishment of an ICOM implementation committee on several aspects of administrative aspects, I would say. And the recommendations of the committee included an annual online volunteer induction and refresher program, which was called VIP. And for this year, it was the duty of the Professional Activities Committee led by Sunita Ma'am to execute it. And they have done it very well. Another one was nominations and appointment committee and leadership structure for Kerala section redefinition, which was again supported. This time it was supported by the leadership. ICOM supported the selection of leadership for 2022. Another one was to develop a transparent process of organizing meetings, for which we already had started developing an application called as Mint, and that has been approved by ICOM. Two different guidelines are being developed, the volunteer interaction guideline and the communication within section. Both the guidelines are ready for publication, and it will be the duty of the next committee to actually implement them. And also, please note that we have a grievance redressal cell constituted in 2020, and the details of which are available in IEEEKerala.org's website. Let me go through the activities of different organization units and standing committees. Let's start with Strategic Initiative on Industry Engagement. It was led by Mr. Satish, and I've conducted several programs, and I'll be displaying only a few of them, and the most important one. And you can see from the count, we have 3,700 plus events, out of which only 3,100 are professional events, and all others are 3,100 student events, and all others are professional events, which means there's a lot of work being done by the professional societies. They conducted an event called Productivo Prime, which was in association with SR Kerala for MSME community in Kerala, and also had a discussion with KDISC to join hands in terms of the knowledge mission initiative of the government of flagship event, the 10th edition of Roadmap to Success in Engineering Studies for 10th and 11th and 12th students. And today, national workshop on women in engineering entitled the Beyond Glass Barriers, which was organized on 28th and 29th December at NIT Calicut. These are some of the photographs, and they also released a decennial souvenir at NIT Calicut on 30th October 2021. IEEE Kochi subsection. This is the statistics. They have 13 events held during the year. They played a major role in establishing the Photonics Society chapter in Kerala. And coming to the award section, the Best Volunteer Award was given to Binu A, Assistant Professor of Rajagiri School of Engineering Technology, and a special certificate of appreciation were given to Ganesh Shekhar of ECC and Harita Sharda of Little Apple Academy, USC. And these are the events, includes the Arten-sponsored POCO workshop and the IEEE Day celebrations. And I should also mention the HAC project completion by Bijoy Ajos within the jurisdiction of Kochi subsection. These are some of the photographs of various events. This is the Exicom new of 2022. Inter-society relations led by Harindral sir, I completed 52 webinars on all Wednesdays, and that's relentlessly on all Wednesdays. And totally, they've completed 91 webinars from 2020 onwards. There are a variety of topics covered. Many renowned speakers from India and abroad actually deliver their share their experience on these webinars. Professional activities, as I told you, they completed the VIP programs as per the schedule for training the refresher course for new volunteers or existing volunteers. These are some photographs of the events. There are many events I should mention, and three top events are ARISE 2021, Upscale, and SOT. And I should say for the ARISE 2021, there were 600 plus registrations on total. These are some of the events. Life member affinity group, this is a largest in terms of activities. Largest LMAC across the world in terms of activities. The total membership count is just 25. And especially all LMAC members, some of them were actually life members, have been elevated as life senior members this year. So there are no life members, there are only life senior members within Kerala section. Some of the photographs. Young Professional Affinity Group, this is the statistics. There are 1,236 professional members and 457 graduate student members. They have reported 108 events in VTools, and they completed all of them. And the major programs included, as I told you, they've won the IEEE Hall of Fame Award, and then they're part of the STEP, YP Winter Meetup, YP Talks, and a lot of events being organized. These are some of the photographs. The membership statistics again, and this would be the largest OU in IEEE Kerala section. They have 6,880 members as students and 342 professional members. And they've been part of AISY WLC and several events for empowering women and a cyber Suraksha program, which is a train-the-train program in collaboration with the Education Activities Committee of IEEE Kerala section. There are many, we could see a lot of events on the board. There's a gallery. Consultant networks, this is a membership statistics. There are 238 members, Exicom. They've conducted two administrative and two professional events. And if you look at the activities, these are the main activities that have conducted in the last 1 year. And these are some of the photographs. And coming to societies, let me start with Antenna and Propagation Society. this is the statistics of society members, and these are some of the events. The Hello EMI EMC event, Learn to Detect and Decode. There's a 2 weeks program on training, 2 weeks FTP, and there's 1 week FTP in hybrid mode. In hybrid mode on microwave antennas and applications. Then another one was a workshop on space antennas. Circuits and Systems Society, this is the statistics. They have started a new Circuit and Systems Society student chapter at TKM College of Engineering. And they've conducted 12 different events. The major events being the Maker Village Startup Challenge, the 2021 Intelligence in Chip Tomorrow of Integrated Circuits, Undergrad Project Awards. These are some remains of the events. Okay. Computer Society, another one active society, which is the third largest society in the world. There are a lot of members, 3,238 student members. They've conducted 200 plus events in last year, where the most important events being AKCSSE, Elever, and Entrepreneurship Expo. These are this the details of those three events. And this is a gallery of various events. Communication Society has 791 members, as I told you, and they've conducted 36 events, including 4 webinars, 18 talks, 6 workshops, and 8 administrative meetings. And one of the highlight event is the ComSoc Virtual Distinguished Lecture Series, which they, the ComSoc regularly conducts. And there was a monthly online quiz and a grade 7, which was thesis competition. There are several virtual distinguished lectures you can see there. These are some of the photographs connected to those events. EMBS, Kerala is now the 9th largest among all EMBS chapters, and there are a total of 213 members. Again, this is an arrangement issue. They conducted 4 webinars, 11 talks, 1 workshop, 2 panel discussions, 1 industrial visit, etc. And the major events, top events are Synapsys 21, it's a food up program. And one of the highlights is that they are trying to create a directory of biomedical engineers. Education Society is a relatively new society of Kerala. Even then there are 110 members, and they have conducted 45 events maybe in last 6 months or so. The chapter was inaugurated on 14 July, which means roughly 6 months. And then they're part of the RSTEP, Rural Student Technical Enhancement Program, eKites, and the IEEE Infosys Springboard Collaboration, which was actually signed on 23rd of October, 2021. These are some photographs connected to the events. Then geoscience and remote sensing, I don't really get any update on that. And IEEPL society is the only joint chapter society, which has got 3,327 members. They have several events conducted. The most important events being the EV hack in association with the Robert Bosch Solutions Limited, the H4H, the IEEE HSE funded event, and the Stark Expo, which was organized on during 3rd to 5th December 2021. These are some of the photographs of the events. Microwave Theory and Technique Society, MTTS. There are 15 webinars, 12 talks, and 2 workshops. And they have some very good quality, special events, one called as the Learn from Leaders and Learn from Legends talk series. And a Women in Microwave Virtual Colloquium, IEEE Space Antenna Workshop. And these are the speakers of L4 series. And this is the pandemic initiative by MTTS. Power and Energy Society has got, which is the largest society in the world. with 4,505 members, and they've conducted 152 events, out of which one was the EPIC, the International Conference, and then there are several others listed out there. The Women of Wisdom webinar series, STEM at Pre-University Initiative, etc. These are some of the photographs related to those events. Then Photonic Society, again, the newest society in IEEE Kerala Section. They have a few events to list out. The society was inaugurated on 24th August 2021 by the veteran physicist, Professor Ajay Khattak. Then there are some few webinars organized subsequent to that. These are some of the photographs related to those events. Robotics and Automation Society, the total members are 1,020. I think they reached 1,000 very recently. But this is the largest society, RAS society chapter in the world. They conducted a lot of events, most important being the roadway to robotics, Aryantra, Droid, Rex robotic experience program, etc. These are some of the photographs. Signal Processing Society has got 22 professional members and 395 student members. They've conducted 7 offline events last year, and the most important event being Forum on Trends in Multiscale Signal and Image Processing for Biomedical Instrumentation, funded by the IEEE SPS. And these are other events organized by the SPS chapter of IEEE Kerala Section. There's some of the photographs related to those events. SSIT, which is a society with the least number of members, but you should note that there was a 100% increase in the membership during last year, though it was from 24 to 56. But you can see that there are a lot of events. They've conducted 11 different events. They conducted a distinguished lecture webinar also on 23rd May 2021. These are some of the photographs related to the events. RFID Council, the only council chapter in Kerala section. Total members are 1,086. They've conducted 6 different events, which includes an RFID challenge, embedded challenge 2.0, and webinar on RFID solutions. These are the details of those events. That's the gallery of those events. The SAI community, students, there are 4,414 students across multiple SAI communities across the state. There are 21 SAI groups, and there were 55 plus events organized, which includes the first Students Humanitarian Technology Conference, along with several pre-events. Okay. Also, there was a site camp organized at the tribal villages of Begur and Bawali in Wayanad to identify the problems of tribal community, wherein 30 volunteers and student representatives from various site groups participated. You can see that site camp photo at the end, bottom right. Now, student activities, I'll give just the activities. Statistics, there are 88 active student branches out of 109 actually formed within Kerala section, with 11,418 student members who have reported 3,100 plus activities in the year. It's 2021. I was supposed to correct it. I'm sorry. And this is the statistics of the student branches across different hubs. Malabar Hub has 25 SBs. Kochi has 38 active out of 41. Travancore has 12 active. And we are present on the web in various channels. I don't know how many of you actually subscribe to all these channels, but we have a Facebook page. We have a Twitter account, Instagram, LinkedIn, also YouTube channel, wherein we stream all the videos of all the events. Most of them go live on our YouTube channel. Okay. And this is the statistics of growth, the follow growth in the social media presence. Thank you. That's all.
I would request the members to approve the secretary's report in the AGM. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Gilesh. Thank you for that crisp presentation. We are slightly behind schedule because of the glitches that happened earlier. I will request Dr.
Permission, I am presenting the financial report of IEEE Kerala section for the year 2021. Yes. So the report is from 1st January 2021 to 31st December 2021. The opening balance of IEEE Kerala section as on 1st January 2021 is 1.58 crores. The income received during this period is 1.47 crores. The total expense in the year 2021 is 2.39 crores. So the closing balance is 66.44 lakhs. And out of this, we have some payables, the payables for different projects funds, SB rebates, etc. comes around 20 lakhs. Then we have plenty of payables for various funds to be delivered to various societies, that comes around 31 lakhs. So the balance after these deductions comes around 14 lakhs. So out of this, we have already committed other expenditure like AGM expenses, other expense to follow. Then we are planning an award night by the end of January. Then we have a few receivables also. Please continue with the same slide, Alan. Yeah. So we have a few receivables also because we have given some advance to some societies. So that comes around 4.22 lakhs. So the actual balance is 4.55 lakhs. This is a financial statics of IEEE Kerala section. As on 31st December, if you have any clarifications, I am ready to attend.
I will then request the members to kindly pass the financial report.
Thank you,
Biju, for that crisp presentation. Coming ahead is another vibrant set of activities which will be reported by Professor Shankar Jayaraj, the Student Activities Chair for 2021. He'll be presenting in some detail the Student Activities Report.
So warm good evening, everyone, respected dignitaries on the dais and off the dais. Okay, so before we begin, I would like to thank the link team as well as all the Execom members who have wholeheartedly supported the student activities to make a new standard that I would like to share. Because when we begin on a particular journey, it was actually, there's a time in which the student members were there, like around for 7,000 to 8,000. So there was a meeting there conducted, like what we can do to ensure the student members are actually more into the community as well as they include in all the activities. So a big kudos to the student activity team, especially the VSACs and all the student members, and big kudos to that. So with that, we had a vision to do more for having more interconnected events, parallel events that is collaborated with all section entities. That was one of the main vision that we had in this year. And with that, we want to engage all the student members, both leadership wise volunteering wise as well as activity wise and enlarging into the technical activities. That was a vision that we had done this year. So as a result, you can see the membership of the student count, which has been grown to a next level. So we have reached the 5-digit count for the student members. So big kudos to all the section volunteers, the students, and all the EXICO members, and wholehearted thank you for all the supports. So we have reached 109 total student branches, and out of that we have 85 student branch that is very active, and we have reached the 5-digit count of 11,418 student members. And another peak of event is that we are now marked the 3K total events, 3,422 plus events, and we have reached more than 108 link events or hub events. So we have reported all 3,000 plus events. And another important to note is globally, the student members, we IEEE Kerala section stands first. So this is the statistics of the hub wise. And another important point is that we have started new student branches. So that is a good note. And another thing is that starting student branches is one thing, but reviving the old one is also equally important. So with that note, I would like to congratulate the link team as well as the MD team with Karthik and Thomas, who have done a tremendous job to bring in more student branches as well as to engage the old members. So we have the new VAGs coming up, as well as another important fact is with collaboration of all society chapters. Thanks, a big note for all the student leadership among the society members. This is a quick highlight on the number of new chapters that has evolved. That is 37 plus, which is really remarkable. Big kudos to all the society volunteers, student volunteers, as well as the section leaders to that. And this is a distribution of the chart of activities that has happened for the link as well as the hub. And moving on with that, last year we had one award that is coming up. So for all activities that is we are doing, the awards is the recognition that is the effort of the volunteers they have put in. So award is a recognition for all those. And compared to the previous year, we are the triple award winners this time with Dr. Bneistar, Deepa ma'am, as well as Pradhiva ma'am. We go to kudos all the winners. And next, this is actually quite a repetition. But thank you, Sunita ma'am, for bringing the laureate to us. And as always, link team has been primarily connecting all the student members with the POCs, and the vibrant student members had secured this again, IC awards, Thomas, Navineet, and Rohit. A big kudos to all the volunteers. A big kudos to all the volunteers. And then we have the CS REM scholars as usual. Okay, so Anne Rose, and Badra is a SR. And next, IACMD Robert is Jarin Peter. A big kudos to Jarin. And outstanding student branch chapter, Nitin of IRTSB. And this is a new time in which a student volunteer of the team, the IEEE Link team, MD, Reema Shaji of Malabar Hub team, got an opportunity. It has been elaborately covered in all newsletters. A good coverage story. A big kudos to her as well as the entire team who has supported her. And moving on, as I said earlier, whatever recognitions, Kerala section has been the role model for all section 343 sections globally. But having that recognition is important for all the student branches. So compared to previous year, out of 109, we have 88 SBs. In that 88 SBs, 19 SBs has got a global award recognition. This is actually the first time in which we have marked the threshold. And big thanks to the link team, in which we have conducted an awards awareness session, which has prolonged for 6 months, which is actually a good dedication that volunteers had put. A big kudos to the volunteers who have trained with the all previous awardee winners. So moving on, we have Rajagiri with Exemplary Award. We have 9 Exemplary Awards, as well as Darrington Activity Awards, Bronze and Gold category, and SPA funding, RAS. So I'll just moving on quickly. Since awards are more, we will take more time, but I am trying to elaborate as quickly as possible. So we have Sun Joseph, which has been vibrant for all of the years with all the activities. We can just see out the list. And there are 19 such HBs that has been there. Chertala for, and Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Technology for IAS, Darrington, Bronze. I think we should all deserve, we should give a good round of applause to all the student members from the EXICOM itself. and Government Engineering College with Director Award, as well as there are two awards that they have won. It's not a single event. The two events got pictured. This is the first time in which they get two types. And Federal Institute with the CES as well as the RAS getting appreciation and being funded upon. And Muthoot College for Hack and SAP. And Government Engineering College, Kannur. And the point to note is that about the Kannur is that they have been a one of the best SPs, which have produced a lot of volunteers for the student, for the section, for all the leaders. And they have been recognized as IC best branch also. And Assembly Award, as well as activities. And they have surpassed the limit that a SP could have. And Jawaharlal College for the Ryan John Award, Renewer, IAS, most of it won an IEEE class in the previous year. And Regional Exemplary Award for the College Engineering Adur. And Sri Siddhartha Tirunal for the MGA Regional Exemplary Award again. And Vimal Jodi, Mar Athenaeus College. And just to note, the point is that while beginning of this year, by March and April, our team had a discussion. We need to do something more. For all years, we have been conducting all Kerala Student Congress. But this year, after the pandemic, it will be a great exposure for the student community, the young professional, the members, the life members, and the members to host our own All India Student Young Professional Life Member Congress. So we have put forth an application forward, and we are glad that we could conduct. And thanks to MA College that they have been the co-host for the big event. So a big appreciation for the Mar Athenaeus College. And UKF College for IAS Most Appealing Award this year also two times. And Barton Hill for the Outstanding Branch Award for MTS as well. Big round of applause, everyone. I know it's a long list we have, but we should show the appreciation for all. Okay, then Marine College, moving on very quickly. And Thirukkapur, NS College. And these are the awards that I've conducted. This is a last activity of 2020 in which volunteer Amira, Ruben, and Joel, Srijal, Devika, a big round of everyone. I'm just moving. And Dr. Arun, Rajagiri School, SET, Jawaharlal College, and two events, VFS and VCLOCIM. A big round of applause for all the members. And this year, we have started a lot of clubs. But if you see, we are seeing a student branch at a higher level, if you are seeing our OU at least. So we are starting from 700 member club, 600, 500, and earlier years, we are looking into 200 plus club. So a big approach to all the student branches who had made and effectively ensure that these members renews and goes about. Kudos to all members. So this is activity. So if you see the student members, we have 700 members plus 600 plus 1, 500 plus 2, 400 plus members, 1, 300 plus 1, and 200 plus 11, and 100 plus 27 members. So you can see the vibrancy of the student branches overall Kerala. So big round for all the branches who are very active. And moving on, we had a very wonderful year with starting with the link face-to-face, which has done virtually. And this is a signed week celebration. Moving on very quickly. This is an MD initiative that this is where it started all for the membership. And these are the activities and the technical flagship event, Texosium, with 500 plus participation, which is virtual. And this is where it's all start. Awareness of IEEE Student Awards, which you are seeing the result. And Reliance is the program for Region 10 MD Development Kit. And it has been a very wonderful gift. Kudos to the entire student team. And Exicom trainings followed by MD training, online link competitions. And to, as I note in ending note, this is actually where the student have met after 2 years of their volunteering. So this is the where which all the volunteers got recognized. So it has been very vibrant. On this note, I would like to thank the All Kerala Young Professional for the back-end support to all the student members, and everyone has been put in. A special kudos to the VSACs who has been a great model, Bijana ma'am, Vargi sir. So this is the first time in which we got the industry sponsorship for All India Congress. So the Kerala sections have marked a new model for the next years to come as well. So big kudos to that. And we had different events that is coming up, Pursuit of Happiness for the Mental, War, Malabar Subsection, Webinars, that is happening. And then finally, Link Camp. So this year, you can see a lot of association with all the, mostly all the societies. So this is the support that each and every society that gives with the student branch. So with that, in collaboration with the band and with all the vision intact, we will all still move forward to ensure the student members get benefited. That is the finally that thing. So this year we looking forward for the next year with a 15 plus membership for students. And just a quick highlight on the V. And these are the association that we have done for all the events as such. And thanks to Sharda ma'am, Goma sir, Samir sir, and all the XCOM members for the big support as well as the guidance in need for conducting all those events. And thank you so much. So this is a team that made all this happen. So a big round of applause to the lean team that here, Sri Lakshmi, Melvin, Joel, Anvinda, Anamika, and Adivadhan, and the SR support, Bhadra, Suraj, Awad, Alan, Nishant. A big kudos to everyone. And with the VSACs are the pillars, I would say. So Josna ma'am, Abhirami, Thomas, Pranav, Arundhati, Anu ma'am, Arjun, Alvin, Rosa, and Srividya, Sean, Anaga, Basil, Femi, and Archana. And along with that, this is the pillar with Karthik. The support of Karthik has been tremendous. The Somers, IB, Professor Nandan, Sabri sir, and everyone. And Fida, Genga, Irene, and Reema. Reema, congratulations again because we are making this proud. And thank you so much for being a patient listener. And we expect a lot of support in student, and we can ensure that we have set a new model for the global level assets. And thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you, Shankar. Your excitement is very contagious. You can see the vibrancy of the student activities, the way he's presenting. And I think he has taken a lot of efforts to condense it to too much to keep it within the time. So now is the right time to celebrate. We should also have some celebration, right? We have become the largest section in the world. And Karthik is coming here with a big cake for cutting. He's holding on his own. He can't hold the cake. You can see how he's coming. There he goes. He's keeping on the table. Yeah. Please, let's all come up and yeah. Please come and join the celebration, maybe.
When I tell everyone that you're in love with me, congratulations and jubilations. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. Who would believe?
let you walk into my heart. Congratulations and celebrations when I tell everyone that you're in love with me. Congratulations and jubilations. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. I was.
Thank you everyone for celebrating our position and also for all the members. Next agenda item is actually the announcement of the new office bearers. This year we had followed a process which is aligned with MGA and also MGA guidelines and also our bylaws. I will now request Mr. Shashi PM, who is member of the nomination committee of IEEE Kerala section for 2021, to kindly announce and also do the honors.
Very good evening once again. The nominations process for finding the office bearers of IEEE Kerala section for the year 2022 started by the chair, who constituted a nominations committee with Satish Babu as a chairperson, Professor V.K. Damodaran and myself as members. The nominations were invited for the positions of chair, vice chair, secretary and treasurer through e-notice. And the last date was 1st November, which was extended till 6th November to get more nominations. So out of the nominations we received, there were some withdrawals. So three positions for the chair, secretary and treasurer. After the withdrawals, we had only one nomination each. For the chair position, Mini Olanate. Secretary position, Bijoy Jose. Treasurer position, Biju K. But for the vice chair position, there were two candidates, even after the withdrawal time. And those were Muhammad Qasim S. and Gilesh MP. And then since there are two candidates for one position, a Tellers committee was formed on 6th December with the following members. Mr. Unni Shankar as chair, Dr. Gogu Umar A as member, and Dr. C.K. Anandan also as member. And then election was conducted for the position of vice chair. Voting was from 12th of December to 28th of December. And as communicated by the Tellers committee, Professor Muhammad Qasim S has been elected as the vice chair. So thus we have the final list of office bearers for IEEE Kerala section 2022. Chair Mini Ulanat, vice chair Muhammad Qasim, secretary Bijoy Jose, who is not online, sorry, he is only online, and treasurer Biju K. These are the positions of the office bearers for IEEE Kerala section 2022. I request Mini to join here the stage. And there were a lot of support from ICOM. I would like to extend our thanks to ICOM, chaired by Amatanath Raja, and of course the nomination committee, chaired by Satish, and also the Tellers committee chaired by Unni Shankar and all others who contributed to this one. Thank you so much. Welcome the new members. Congratulations to the new office bearers, and also thanks and congratulations to the outgoing committee, which has done a wonderful job, as you can see from the presentations. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Shashi, for mentioning the new leaders, and welcome to the new team. Next part on the agenda is actually the address by the outgoing chair. Good evening, everyone. I stand very relieved here. I now understand all the past chairs, how they've earlier stood like this and mentioned during their outgoing session. And I'm very glad that I'm handing over to Mini, who is a very seasoned professional, a wee volunteer, and one of my very best friend. Thank you, everybody, for the support that I have received for the last 2 years, including my team over here, for my team and also the Exicom as such. And the results you have been seeing presented by both Gilesh and also Biju over here, Shankar. We, at least generally what we think is the numbers, the membership number is of course a major matter that we all always have to strive for, but also the meaningfulness of the programs that conduct and how we can attract members through that way is something that we have been focusing in Kerala. We have been able to do that very consistently for the last 2 years. There were a few initiatives which had happened. One was, of course, there were two initiatives, one on industry engagement and academy engagement. The thought process and the directions have all been laid. There have been activities coming up over the past 2 years, and I'm sure it is going to be continued with relevance to the current situation and looking at the Kerala situation as such. I'm sure it could be realigned and then move forward as required. Another point had been a kind of an e-notice. How do you leverage the current, the advancements in terms of software and applications as such for minimizing the efforts for chair, secretary, the ECC, etc., and also for the users per se? This was one thought process that started off in early 2021. And a big thanks to the interns team under the ECC who had taken up the responsibility, and of course the webmaster Neeraj, who had taken up the responsibility and decided that yes, we are going to go one step ahead. I had only asked for a bit, but then they had gone a big deal, and then we had more in no time, which the app which had brought us the first edition of the MGA Innovation Award, and also I'm sure has eased out the processes within our section. There is more aspiration in terms of how do you minimize the efforts that is needed for, say, probably requesting for a fund from the section. Now we are using a lot of, Word files, which is sent to Biju, and then I get to know it. When I say I, the chair gets to know it, and then you need to approve, and then it goes to the section office. They have to see the mail, and then the transfer option happens. So there is an aspiration that those processes, which could be streamlined and
brought with minimum efforts could also be part of mint. Mint, if properly used, will also hold all the reports related to a program which is being initiated to that. So that is a work in progress. I'm sure the next team under the leadership of Mini and also the Exicom will be continuing the efforts going forward. Another very heartening thing for me, and I'm sure for Samir, Suresh sir, the whole team, Mini of course, is how we utilize the funds that was available. Generally, Kerala section doesn't have much fund. You can see Biju had actually shown the report as only 4 lakhs now currently available, because all the funds are provided for meaningful programs. If there is a program which is really good, which is engaging our members, there is no way in our history that we have ever said no to a program because of money. So that has been the legacy we have been continuing. And I'm very glad we have also got, in collaboration with ASA, this is ASA Kerala, in the Nippon Center, we have got a space which could be used as the Kochi hub for our section members to have programs. In fact, the joint chapter team under Bijuna, Biju, etc., have been rigorously utilizing that space ever since it's got. So that's again one very heartening point. The other, of course, you have seen how there were many changes that were brought in, that was tried out, I should say. It's all initiated as part of the implementation committee guidelines. I must specifically thank Amarnath Raja, Dr. Bijuna Kunyu, Mohanda sir, Gopakumar sir, then Madhukumar sir and Shahim, representing different subsections, regionalities, who had come up with recommendations for how do you bring in more volunteers to leadership positions, and how we can support incoming team to get the best of the volunteers to lead Kerala section and also the various entities. I'm very glad the team has actually completely handheld. Special kudos to Amarnath Raja, the way the process has been continued. Of course, we have to have these to be put in our bylaw appropriately. There may be some amendments which may be needed in the process that we have tried out now. That would be, there will be suggestions sought, and I'm sure Mini will be going ahead with the process that is required. There was also this volunteer induction and program, which Gilesh just mentioned over here. This actually came up from the thought process that there are many new members who come to Kerala section. I don't know how many of you know that we are the only section which has 108 members as section, Exicom, including all the entities, the different leaders of all the entities and everybody together. And that is a success of the section too. That's why we have so much of member growth too. So how do we make the new members who come into the our Exicom aware of the different processes followed by IEEE, the legacy of Kerala section, the legacy of IEEE, our processes. There are some processes which are very, very, very peculiar to Kerala section. How do we train them? So a complete module has been made thanks to Bijuna and team, and well implemented by our professional activities chair over here. They have implemented last year different modules which have actually been put in YouTube also, so that new coming volunteers can be trained on that. I'm sure last year the process took almost 6 months, which is not what we were thinking. I'm sure this year it will be done at a much faster pace and more modules will be included. there was also this requirement that the communication related to various programs within the section be streamlined so that every member gets to know what happens in the other entity. And this is now started streamlined through Mint as such. So it's very, very heartening that there are, as the section grows, there are always new improvements that is needed because of the growth. And many of such interventions could be made. Of course, those needs to be streamlined in the coming years. We also, see, Kerala section used to do technical co-sponsorship for various conferences. We have a very stringent guideline, which is recommended by the CAB and also published in our website for any entity to have a technical co-sponsorship. This year, we also brought in strict guidelines for financial co-sponsorship. Now, it has always been the onus by IEEE MGA and also ARTEP that conferences should be, if there is an IEEE tag, it must be the best as IEEE stands for. So the process is very rigorous and we have been able to bring in beautiful conferences in Kerala, helping a lot of professionals and researchers on the go. I must also mention that due to COVID and other situation, there have been a lag in the last 3 years for submission to the registrar of societies. Now, this is a process because Kerala section is actually one of the registered society in Kerala, and the process was slightly delayed, but that was also completed in November, so we are fully complied with that. Also with the IT exemption requirements, those are also been met. We have had I am from industry, so I've been working whenever the occasion comes to that we should have more collaboration with industry, more collaboration between academia and industry. And I'm very glad that joint chapter has really moved ahead. I know every society had been trying that, but joint chapter especially have moved ahead and brought in Bosch in a large scale to the IEEE Kerala section operations. And I also know there are other entities like RAS who have been working along with Tata, then PES with KCB, etc. But prominent among them has been Bosch. We have conducted all the IEEE days. I'm very happy. And it's very heartening that in 2020, Malabar subsection celebrated their 10th year. And in 2021, Kochi subsection celebrated their 10th year. So I've been very happy to be part of both the celebrations. If I take names, there are many people to be thanked. But I will have to say thanks to at least a few, without which I can't step down from here. One is Professor V.K. Damodaran. There have been many instances where I was challenged in my position by different leaders, as is required, because when an entity grows, there can always be a difference of opinions. And those challenges actually brings out the best for the section. And I still remember how sir told me, as you move up the ladder, the people will see only your back. People don't see your front, they'll see only your back. So that is something. And he had been one person who had, whenever I reach out, had tried to, bring me to grounds and say, yes, these are all part of a growth process. Another person has been Satish Babu. Anytime I reach out for the different committees, any kind of operations where you required, Satish was there. Similarly, Amarnath Raja. Of course, Samir has been my sounding board all along. I don't know how many times I've been calling him up and saying things. Suresh sir, though he had been pretty busy with his IC, he was always there. And I have my women team, whom I can completely lean in. Mini, Bijna, and Sunida over here. Anytime, every time, they are there. So, and both the subsection chairs, I must say, Santosh, though initially I was not very familiar with Santosh, I was thinking he sometimes, cracks something and I get,
why is he saying like this? But then I understood he's a person like that. You need to be yeah. And also Sabik is very silent, but very, very, you know, he can pick things pretty fast. Thank you so much, both of you. And of course, my team. I can't say about Gilesh because I don't know how many times I've shouted at you too, Gilesh. I'm really sorry if I've done. And to Bindima, Gilesh has really been supporting. I remember last time something I mentioned. So, and of course, Biju. Initially, Biju had the hiccups as to how the treasurer is and all, but he has really come up understanding each of the nuances anywhere. Kasim sir, I'm meeting for the first time since he took over. We have always been only on phone or chat, and he has been really, really supportive. I don't know if I keep on naming, there are many people whom I should name. And all the live senior members, anytime I reach out, they are there for the different committees for anything to be done. Thank you so much. And of course, I have to really thank, and of course, Vergis, I can see Vergis over here, Nandan, Alan, I don't know, Neeraj, so many people, Anoop, so many over here. Last but not the least, Jayakrishnan, who has been the pillar of strength. Because I have had two major mishaps this year. I fell two times. And all along, all the meetings, everything has been fully put up by him. I thank really him and my family too. I'm sorry if I've exceeded my time. But thank you so much, everything. There's one thing which is a slight regret for me, which I think Mini would take forward. The Student Activities Board of 2020 really worked hard to bring out a Student Activities Operational Manual. By some way, it couldn't be released. I really hope it will come up because it is really required. Our activities, student activities have also really improved. So we need to have such a guideline. I hope it'll come through. I must also thank my amma and also Niranjana, my daughter Amu, who has always been with me together. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. And if I've not named someone, it is because I can't name everyone, but everybody had been with us for the team. And congratulations and all the very best.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your great words, support and guidance. And sorry to interrupt. Before you step down, as a token of gratitude, I request Sri Sashi PM, past chair IEEE Kerala section, to hand over the memento to Sharada ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. I also request Professor Sameer SM, past chair IEEE Kerala section, to hand over the memento to Professor Gilesh. Thank you, sir.
So I'll hand over the mic to Mini. It's addressed by the newly elected chair. I've taken up some time of you.
Respected ITP colleagues and my dear students, a very good evening to all of you. I can feel the sigh of relief at Sharda's face, taking over all the responsibilities. So let me start. Thank you, each and every one of you, for all the encouragement, support, and putting the confidence in me and my team. I accept the position of Chair IEEE Kerala Section 2022, and I consider this role as a call to duty, a call which I'm preparing myself for, willing to undertake, and I want to heartily thank and appreciate senior mentors. Back for a minute. Today, when I just look back, almost a decade back, started my long association with IEEE Kerala Section. And I should say that it has been an incredibly fulfilling and wonderful experience. Stepping up as a chair of student activities of IEEE Kerala Section was a turning point for me in 2012. There I saw the passion and enthusiasm of our students as well as young professionals bringing or conducting events and activities. All along the way, with many trials and errors, I have also started experiencing IEEE. I am eternally grateful to the supportive ecosystem around me, especially, I repeat, my mentors, my peers, all young professionals, students, and the extended family who guided me all through this journey. Over the years, I have been extremely lucky. That is what I consider myself as, taking up various leadership positions, starting with the student activity chair. I moved to computer society. I moved to Kochi subsection. And then 3 years I was there with the women in engineering. And all this thing time, I'm really proud to brag that we achieved new levels of success with our initiatives together as a team. With all this solid foundation, now I know that it is a time to look forward. We saw how much it has been achieved in the last 2 years, but 2022 is, we are seeing a new set of leaders, and it was already mentioned like how the new process has been set in place. So new set of leaders are there to take up the mantle and drive our organization. So let me also express my heartfelt thanks to the ICOM and NOMCOM for implementing the new process into it, and all our major events were executed with a high success rate. Heavy is the head that wears a crown. I can see the relief on Sharda's face. I understand that I have a responsibility of chairing one of the most vibrant and active IEEE sections in the world. We are proving it by every year by the standards, we are raising the bar. So my humble request is all of you should join me in taking our section to the greater heights with all the challenges that we will be facing through. And if the past is an indicator of anything, I stand here proudly while I taken the baton from Sharda, proud of all our accomplishments and ready to face the new challenges. So leadership is all about the shared responsibility, and I still consider it the same. All the things, as she has been pointing out, our team has been the best and the best, I can again and again tell you, because when you talk to others, especially I know the way in which they're asking, oh, you're from Kerala section? Oh, I know that they are very vibrant and your team is very big. When I said that we have 90 plus indexicom, what? 90 plus indexicom, that was the kind of reaction we use. So I still believe that it is all because of our shared responsibility. And so let me just take, I'm not planning for a big lecture or anything, but at least we should have a plan of vision of what does this responsibility can be, how 2022, how we challenge ourselves as a team for better initiatives and programs aligning with IEEE tagline of advancing technology for humanities. So I, as our team, will be mainly focusing on three goals. engage versus membership. We are so happy. We have already celebrated being the global number one, but still, so that makes our responsibility more. We need to engage the members for value proposition. We have always had an upward growth, both in terms of student membership as well as in the professional membership. But is it proportionate, or should we raise the bar again regarding the professional membership? So again, as I told you, we have the shared responsibility, and all the societies, I request, this is a humble request from our team, all the society leadership, please ensure that we are catering to our professional members also. The technical societies should ensure that professionals are catered, and also the activities. See, we are seeing 3,700 activities. And in spite of being in one of the core Exicom, I still found that, oh, some things would have been easier. So one important thing, I think it was already mentioned, the communication should be a little bit strong so that more and more people will be interested in some of the activities. Now, the time has come for us to assume the mantle of leadership. We have proven ourselves to be globally number one. So we need to train in the cutting edge technology, and the leaders should move to the next level also. I think we need to think big. Think big and act local. I think Suresh Nair sir has already always been telling, yes, we saw so many nominations that has come out of Kerala. So I request all the, we as a team will be always promoting the leaders to the next higher level. And one more, or the third point which I wanted to tell you is, we have proven ourselves to be globally number one. So are we having the enough visibility and influence in all levels of technology? Are we consulted or treated as the final word? So we still have a long way to go. So the focus can be more on, focused activities can be more there. And 2018, we saw Kerala floods. And you might have noticed that after that, we have been seeing a lot of disasters one after the other. Disaster preparedness is another thing where the technological interventions can be more. And I think it is our responsibility to look into this also. So more and more activities we will think about. So I just wanted to just share that. And I know growth is not quick and easy when you are in the comfort zone. We do not want to be acknowledged as the best, but it should be the most sought after professional body. Okay. And as a team of volunteers, we pledge to active engagement, committed leadership, and fervent advocacy. Year 2022, we are the host to IndieCon 2022. So let us all start working on it. All helping hands are welcome. And again, let us raise the bar. Let us think big. And I request again all the societies to do their best to bring in the best papers in their tracks or co-locate any events planned during that year. And care has to be taken that no major flagship events or activities clashes the dates proposed. We are proposing second week of November. The dates will be announced after our Exicom. So, as I told you, I don't want to prolong it, but my acceptance would be incomplete without taking this opportunity to thank the outgoing team under the able leadership of Sharda and also Gilesh. So thank you both, because others too are also part of my team. So on behalf of all of us, we are really thankful to you for all the groundwork you have done, all the solid foundation. Yes, definitely we will be continuing all the good work you have started. Okay, thank you. I think as it will be incomplete if I do not mention, I would like to sincerely express my gratitude to some senior colleagues and chair, though I was a member for a long time, as a volunteer, I started under Shashi. I'm extremely thankful to you for bringing me into the front, and I'm all thankful to Sadish, Srini, Suresh Nair, Samir and Sharada, all the chairs with whom I have worked so far. Thank you all. The peer group in the Exicom and my team Kochi. I think it will be very unfair if I do not mention that, because I started my baby steps from there. I can see Shahim here, Sandosh is here, Paul, with whom I started off my work. So, and all my colleagues, I'm not saying all my colleagues with whom I have worked. Thank you all. And my WIE team, already Sharda has mentioned, I have an extended team apart from Bijuna, Sunida and all, because I started again working with Meenakshi, Deepa and a long list. I'm not mentioning all the names, but I have a long list, which is, I don't want to read it out. So I'm really thankful to all of you. And now I would like to welcome all the new members and the Society Council leadership, standing committee chairs, and let us all take the responsibility together. So we still want to say that this journey, we cannot make it alone, but through your support, criticism, encouragements, we will have to do together, and together we shall continue to make it. So on behalf of the incoming team, myself, Kasim sir, Bijoy in absentia, he's joined Zoom, and Biju, wishing you all the very best, happy and prosperous and eventful joy of volunteering in 2022. And let me conclude by acknowledging the support of my husband, Harikrishnan, and my daughter, Kirtana, who has been an untiring support for all my activities. So I remain truly as a volunteer. Thank you very much, and expecting all the cooperation from all of you. Feel free to contact me at any point of time. Thank you. Thank you very much. The next agenda item is reappointment of auditors. I request our treasurer Biju to give the details.
Good evening once again. Ms. Shankarandamurthy has been our auditor for almost over 20 years. And they have been doing a commendable job over these 20 years. They have been doing this auditing. They have been submitting all the reports to this GST complaint, TDS complaints. They have been basically supporting us with all our activities. Though they are continuing as our auditors, we have to comply with certain formalities with regard to the appointment of auditors. Basically, we have to relieve them at the end of every year with effect from 31st December and make them rejoin, or we have to reappointment them at the beginning of every year. That is with starting from 1st January 2020, this year, from 2022 January 1st, we have to reappoint them again. So I need the concurrence of the AGM for the reappointment of our auditors. I request the concurrence of AGM for that. Thank you. Thank you.
The forum is open for general discussions. Request you to come up with any of your ideas or thoughts on how things can be improved.
For those who have joined on Zoom, please raise your hand if you have any questions. Anybody want to discuss something? Please raise your hands.
Is it because we are getting late for dinner? No, not yet. I think yes, we are on time. Any of the members who has joined through Zoom? Oh, okay.
It was mentioned that I think geosensing or GIS, there was not mentioned in the report. Geosensing or I don't know, GIS, it was mentioned. Yes. So I would like to have more information about that. And then do we have a society like security and safety or GIS and CAD, et cetera? Or is it falling in computer society?
Sir, can you please repeat this last part?
Okay. GIS and security.
First part I got it. That is, okay. It was not mentioned.
Okay.
Second part, is there a society for?
Security and safety.
Okay.
Do you have any society? And I have one more question about the audit report. Is there any recommendation or comments from the auditors to AGM?
Okay. So there are three parts. I request Gilesh to answer the first part, GRSS. There was...
GRSS has been it's an integral part of the section. But last year, because of several reasons, the chair could not attend the meetings, and he could not actually report any activities to the Execom. And that's why we just need to mention that there's a society chapter, but there were no activities reported as such.
The third one, I request Biju to
answer. No specific comments from auditor side to basically AGM, but they had sought for some clarifications, and we had cleared that, and we are supposed to approve the AGM in the upcoming special AGM. Basically, it is our executive committee. So no specific comments to AGM. Thank you.
Security and privacy, or you mentioned security and safety?
Safety.
There is no society like that, but there is a special interest group in computer society regarding the cyber security. I don't know whether you meant the same thing, but there is no society for security and safety. GIS specifically.
GIS, CAD, etc.
I think we'll check and then get back to you. It is related to GRSS, so probably we can, I'm not able to answer right now. We'll check and get back to you. Thank you.
Can you please expand that GIS?
I mean geographic information systems.
Okay. GIS also. We do have electrical engineers, we do have another GIS system also, that is the gas switchgear insulated substations.
So if there are no other questions, may I request Dr. Biju to deliver the vote of thanks.
good evening once again. Respected Chair, IEEE Kerala Section, Dr. Mini Ullanat, and other dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, and dear EXECO members. This year 2021 has been an awesome year for IEEE Kerala Section. We crossed over 13,000 members, and we had over 3,500 activities. And I have been lucky being a part of a very vibrant team led by Ms. Sharada Jayakrishnan Madam and Dr. Gilesh. And they have done a wonderful, they have provided a wonderful leadership to us. And I really look forward to work with the new team led by Dr. Mini Ullanat. And I hope the Kerala section would be targeting, as she mentioned in her acceptance speech, we are setting a new goals, and we'll be trying to accomplish that also in the future. So without taking many more time, let me come to my duty of proposing vote of thanks. First, our outgoing chair, I don't know how to thank Sharada Madam, because over this 1 year in 2021, amidst this pandemic period, she has led IEEE Kerala section with some strong shoulders, and she, for new people like me to the post of treasurer and all, she mentored me, she guided me, and the whole EXECOM, I am sure they got many advices and help from Sharada Madam, and not only to the EXECOM members, all our IEEE Kerala section members, including student members. So on behalf of IEEE Kerala section and my personal behalf, I extend my sincere thanks to Sharada Madam. Thank you, Madam. Next, our Vice Chair, Kasim Sir, we all know how a passionate volunteer he has been in IEEE Kerala section. And since I came to IEEE Kerala section EXECOM, in fact, Kasim Sir was the man behind motivating me towards more IEEE activities and coming to IEEE Kerala section. And he has been, as a mentor, being a senior, means very senior person in the IEEE Kerala section fraternity, he has been mentoring all of us, including, we know how much effort he has taken in the membership development activities also. With his, also, in addition to that, membership development team led by Mr. Karthik, Kasim Sir has also taken additional efforts in bringing this membership count to 13,000 plus members. Let me thank Kasim Sir on behalf of IEEE Kerala section and my personal behalf. Thank you very much, sir. Next, our outgoing, very vibrant, young, but very silent, but behind screen, he is very, very active. Dr. Gilesh, I know personally because I have been very much associated with, almost calling many times, at least in a week. And I know how much effort he has taken in preparing reports, in scheduling meetings and other discussions, because secretary has to be mandatorily there, because secretary basically is the convener of every meetings. So secretary has to mandatorily attend all the meetings and prepare the minutes, report, etc. So very, very commendable job. In fact, I personally miss Gilesh in that office wear group. So thank you, Gilesh, for all the effort you have been taking over the years. Thank you very much. Next, our newly elected chair, Dr. Mini Ullanat. I know her personally. I am also basically belongs to Kochi subsection, and she has been a very good friend of me also. And we know how a potential member she has been. And she has been there in that WI International Voting Member Committee. Now she has been promoted to a member at large in IEEE Computer Society, and we have a very new, another potential our senior member as our chair. So thank you, Mini Madam, for taking this responsibility, all the supports to IEEE Kerala section. Now I should mention two immediate past chairs who has been extending tremendous support to me, Dr. Suresh Nair sir and Dr. Samir sir. So both of them have been very good friend of me and very good mentor for me. So in his absentia, thanks to Suresh Nair sir for his all advices, and they have, and very another advantage for us that from Kerala section, we have two people representing Arton and India Council. So thank you, Samir sir, and thank you, Suresh Nair sir, for all the support. So next, once I took that treasurer job initially, as Sarada Madan told, it is a new kind of job because we are basically doing the technical kind of activities. This treasurer kind of job is an entirely different job for us. So initially I had to consult Sunita Madam many times, and she has extended all the support for me in preparing the financial report and in clarifying all doubts. So thank you, Sunita Madam, for all the support being the past treasurer extended to me. Then of course the section management committee and section executive committee consisting of all our members, they have been means extending all support to all IEEE Kerala section activities, involving in all IEEE Kerala section activities and executive committee meetings, management committee meetings, and giving necessary directions to all the office bearers and even student volunteers all. So thank you all executive committee members of IEEE Kerala section. Then my personal thanks to my office people. Basically, I should never forget to thank them, Mr. John and Ms. Saraswati, for all the support. So when I reach out to them for any preparing, some helping in financial reports and all, and John also has been doing a very hectic job in preparing the accounts. And also thanks to John, Saraswati and Vijay Kumar from the office side for all the support extended. So our hotel management team and event management team, they have been doing all the support, and we are having a very good open air, like an open air theater. And this hotel management team has given us all the supports, including giving a very good accommodation and all. So thank you all the hotel management team and all the event management team for all the support extended to this annual general meeting. I once again thank our all live senior members, members, graduate student members, student members, and all volunteers of IEEE Kerala section for all the support extended to IEEE Kerala section activities. Thank you. Thank you again.
We have a photo session. Request all of you kindly join for the photo session, and which will be followed by the dinner, which is ready on the right side. The annual general meeting, the formal event is closed. Thank you. But also the meaningfulness of the programs that conduct and how we can attract members through that way.
ഇവിടെ സീറ്റിൽ ഇരിക്കാമെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് ഫോട്ടോ എടുക്കാം, ഒരു മൂന്ന് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നാല് ഇതായിട്ട് എല്ലാവരുടെയും ഫോട്ടോ എടുക്കാം. പ്ലീസ് കം ടു കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ദ ഫോട്ടോ സെഷൻ. ചെയർ, ഇമ്മീഡിയറ്റ് ഫസ്റ്റ് ചെയർ, ന്യൂ ചെയർ, ടീം, പ്ലീസ് കം, ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു പ്ലീസ് കം. വി കൻ ടേക്ക് ദ ഫോട്ടോ സെഷൻ ഇൻ ത്രീ ഗ്രൂപ്സ് ഓർ ഫോർ ഗ്രൂപ്സ്.